Listen to the start of this song. Okay, that's enough of this. This is almost certainly going to be blocked for some copyright claim or other, and there's not a lot I can do about this. Today is the 17th of September, and on this date in 1982, The Clash released their double A-side single. On one side was Straight to Hell, and on the other side was one of my favourite songs, Should I Stay or Should I Go? Now, I think it's lots of people's favourite songs, and great, but I thought, this all deserves something. So, put on combat rock. This is the vinyl I'm listening to. I've owned this for over 40 years now, because the album came out 42 years ago, and I still love it. And I thought I'd put on the t-shirt, because let me take you through a little walk through memory lane. This is me, a picture of me interrailing in Europe in 1986, when I had just gone to university. There you can see me chatting to just two random women I've met traveling on a train, wearing this exact same t-shirt. No, it's not the same t-shirt. I think I was skinnier then, and it was probably a size smaller, and I lost it at some point, but I loved it. I owned it before I went to university. I wore it all through university, and then at some point in my post-university life, I probably wore it so much, it just fell to pieces. But nonetheless, I wanted to do something to mark this. And I also wanted to do this, and I've got a very good name for this cocktail that I found on the on Difford's Guide, because I've told several people, in fact I've told everyone who can be bothered to listen to me, that when I die and it's my funeral, I have a certain request. I was thinking in my mind, and I put this in my will, that I wanted to be in a coffin, about to be cremated, on a conveyor belt, just like if you imagine in James Bond in Diamonds Are Forever, where he goes in and he doesn't get burnt in the crematorium, but it'd be like that, be in there, everyone's at the funeral, well, if anyone's there, of course, might be no one showing up, but I'm in the coffin and it's going along and then the conveyor belt stops and then on comes this song. And if anyone doesn't laugh, those people are not invited to the party afterwards. I've told everyone this. Hopefully, my wishes are respected, because I think it would just be a blast. Anyway, the name of this cocktail is Death Star. I was looking at if there's something with funeral in it, or even let's look at the word should I stay or should I go, something with the Spanish lyrics, but couldn't find anything. But Death Star seems like quite a relatively good name, actually, especially because there is a track on the album. It's the last one on the album, called Death is a Star. And as I said, I love this album. I'm still listening to it today. It's a class album. So why wouldn't you mark the date of this song that just finished, about to be Rock the Casbah? Why wouldn't you mark that with a cocktail? Luckily, super easy cocktail. I should do it before all my ice melts in my glasses and things. It is a 3-ingredient cocktail plus bitters. First ingredient we're putting in is some pisco. And it's an equal measurement, so I'm just going to put in an ounce of each. That makes life really easy. I spill a little bit, so let's just top that up. Let's hope I managed to keep the proportions right, but I'm fairly sure I did. Next ingredient, 1 ounce of Strega, an Italian liqueur, sort of slightly anise. Delicious, really do like it. And there we go, 1 ounce of that. Didn't spill any this time. I'm quite proud of myself. Last ingredient, another Italian ingredient, Cynar, that artichoke, aperitivo that you can make a spritz with, like with Aperol, but it's artichokey instead, it's a bit more bitter. We are going to have 1 ounce of that as well. Like I say, it's equal measurements, so whatever you have to measure, just make sure they're all the same for those ingredients. Final ingredient, 1 dash of grapefruit bitters, like so, and we're going to give that a nice stir. Actually, it was funny. I had a heart episode a few years ago. Things were looking quite dicey. I had to go out for some tests. And Kate was in the car with me, because I need someone to maybe drive me back home. I might have needed stents, who knows what. They were concerned enough, they wanted to check me out. So we're driving up now. I'm listening to my music on my playlist. And Kate was like, oh, I'm just bored. She wasn't bored with it, but she was like, yeah, can we change this? Okay, so she plugged in her phone and just went to her, I don't know if it's a random mix, but it's just a mix that she listens to on a regular basis. And we're driving up there for my heart stuff. And the first song that comes on her mix is, Should I Stay or Should I Go? Oh my God, that is not a good sign. But actually, it wasn't a bad sign. Here I am, making cocktails, still not dead yet. All right. That is chilly enough. And then we just strain, and I like this into Rock the Casbah as well. I always show, I show a whole bunch of music videos in my developing, the Politics of Developing Nations class. And I teach that in the summer. And this one is, this is just a great video as well. Okay, I'm talking too much, I can tell on that. 5.5 minutes already. People start switching off and I haven't even poured the drink out. Anyway, pour this. I've got a nice large ice cube in my glass. And I'm just going to pour this in there. It is a gorgeous brown color and that ice cube is just floating nicely on top. But wait, there's one more ingredient. There's a great garnish. It's a Death Star, right? It's, you know, deathy. But it's not, we're not doing anything, well, it is dead, I suppose, what we're going to put in. We're going to get these things and it's kind of very cool. There we go, we're gonna float on top. Let's find a nice one. It is a whole bunch of them earlier on. At least I could, oh, there you go. There's a pretty one. A star anise. And that just gets floated on top. Actually, look at that. But if you can see that, you could just rest that on top of the ice cube. So when you drink it, you get a great big whiff of that star anise. And that is a potent spice right there. Let's see what we've got. Well, cheers. With this, you're really gonna have to decide whether you should stay or whether you should go.